गुड इवनिंग सर, माय नेम इज़ वंशी भरद्वाज एंड नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द बेसिक्स ऑफ मैटलैब। बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस वीडियो आई वांट टू इंटीमेट यू अबाउट वन थिंग। फॉर सम रीजन माय वेबकैम इज अनेबल टू रिकॉर्ड फॉर मोर देन 10 मिनट्स, सो आई वुड बी एक्सप्लेनिंग द कोर्स फास्टली, सो प्लीज एक्सक्यूज इफ देर एनी ग्रामेटिकल एरर्स। सो या लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। या सो आई हैव, एज यू कैन सी, आई हैव ऑलरेडी टाइप्ड द कोड एंड एग्जीक्यूटेड इट। So I will be explaining the each code on the line. So this is the way we can assign a vector to a variable, and this is the way we can perform operations on a vector: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. And this is the syntax for creating a matrix of m rows and n columns. Here this semicolon separates each row, and here y is equal to x transpose. This is the way we can create a transpose of matrix. And x star y, x star y is a normal multiplication of matrices, but x dot star y is the multiplication of corresponding elements of the matrices. So we can see here, this is x, this is y, and this is x star y, and this is x dot star y. This is corresponding multiplication, this is normal multiplication. So yeah, next, this is the way we can extract a row or column of a matrix, and this is the way we can create a submatrix of a given matrix, and this is the way we can delete a row or column from a given matrix. This is x equal x star of. Yeah, here the first row will be eliminated. So yeah, let's go to the next code. Here x is equal to 0 to 0.1 to 2 pi. This implies that x is from 0 to 2 pi, and y is sin x, z is cos x. Subplot 1 to 1, plot xy, subplot 1 to 2, plot xz. This plot function is used to plot the graph, and subplot is used to create represent both the graphs in the same box. Here 1 2 indicates the, if we consider this box as a matrix, we can see that it is a 1 by 2 matrix, and first element is plot of xy, second element is plot of exit. So yeah, let's go to the next code. This is again x is from 0 to 2 pi, and y is sin x, z is cos x. Plot of xy is hold on. Hold on statement is used to draw both the graphs in the same box, and grid on statement is used to create the grid, as we can see here. This legend statement is used to indicate the name of the graph, both the graphs. Here we can see it. Blue line indicates sine wave, red line indicates cos wave. And x label, y label, title are used to name the x axis, y axis, and title of the graph respectively. And again, grid on is used to draw the grid. So yeah, let's go to the next code, and we can see a time, amplitude, and sine wave. So yeah, let's go. Yeah, this is the way. This is for a quadratic equation which you have gave the question in our assignment. This is root 1 minus b plus or minus square root of discriminant by over 2a, and this is the graph of the equation in the assignment. We can see from minus 5 to 10. The y values are in this way, and again grid on statement is used to draw the graph. So well, let's go to the next code. Yeah, MATLAB is mostly consists of arrays and matrices, because the full form of MATLAB is matrix laboratory. So there are many inbuilt functions for matrices. So let's explore some of the most important ones. Here you can see C code I of 2 is, I is nothing but identity matrix of order 2. We can clearly see it here. And D is zeros of 2, all the elements will be zeros. F equal to 1s of 2, all the elements will be 1s. And this is the way we can create a matrix 2 by 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. And concatenation. Concatenation is nothing but simply attaching one array and another array subsequently. And horizontal concatenation is attaching horizontally, and vertical concatenation is attaching vertically. We can clearly see it here, that this is the horizontal concatenation 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, and vertical concatenation is all the three matrices are attached vertically. We can see AAA and AAA. And diagonal function is used to extract the diagonal elements of the matrix. And now I have created a 3 by 3 matrix, and these two functions provides us the lower and upper triangular matrix respectively. And we can see this is the lower triangular matrix, this is the upper triangular matrix of the given matrix. So yeah, let's go to the last code. Yeah. Now I have created a variable a and a vector v. Now I will be explaining the loop. I will be explaining the loops here. Now for while loop with the condition a is less than equal to 5 and v equal to v plus 1 a equal to, as long as the a satisfies this condition in the while loop, the statement gets repeatedly executed, and once the a value crosses 5, the statements in this while loop will be stopped executing, and the control will be gone to the next one. Here we can see as a is equal to 4, v is increased by 1, and again a equal to 5, v is increased by 1. As a equal to 6, this condition is failed, so v is not increased, and the control is gone to the for loop. Now for for loop, this is the general formula, general way of writing it. B equal to 1 to 10, If B is, now I will be explaining all this in on one code. If, else if, break, continue, end. Break statement is used to break out of the loop, and continue statement is used to continue the loop again for the next value. And if and else if, end values are used for conditional statements. Now if B is greater than 5, then the loop will break. Else if B is greater than 3, then the loop will continue. If both are not satisfied, then B will be printed out. Now for B equal to 1, we can see here B is 1 is printed. Both the conditions are failed, the B is 1 is printed. Again for 2 and 3, the same values 2 and 3 are printed. Once B goes to 4, the else if condition is satisfied and the loop is continued for B equal to 5, the next value. Again for B equal to 5, the else if statement is satisfied. Again it will be run for B equal to 6. Once B equal to 6 is achieved, the first statement is satisfied and the loop is broken. So in this way the code will be run. And for the last one, this is the nested loops. And for A equal, I have taken a basic example for A equal to 1 to 2 and for B equal to 1 to 5, A plus B and N. Now, the inner loop will be run for each and every value of A in the outer loop. Now, for A, that is, for A equal to 1, the B value runs from 1 to 5, and again for A equal to 2, B value runs from 1 to 5. So, A plus B values are correspondingly printed here. So, yeah, that's it, sir. Thank you. I am really sorry for the inconvenience. And I will be giving you the entire code in the WordPad, so I hope you can understand. Thanking you.